Welcome to the tropical island of... Just kidding. As much as I'd like to tell you our photojournalism project is from some warm tropical place, it's not. It's from right here in a little town called Yarmouth, Maine. For those of you interested, I'm Hillary, and joining me today is... Reed. For our project, we'd like to show you what a typical day is in the life of...
Da-da-da-da! Hillary and Reed!
I start my morning by getting up and driving myself and my little sister to school, usually blasting some sort of weird song of Lady Gaga. We're not always in the best moods in the morning either, but that's a different story. As we pull into school, we always find someone to say hi to in the morning, whether we're fully awake or not.
While Reed's driving to school with her sister, I'm upstairs in my room trying on about 20 million outfits before I find the right one, or go back to the one I was wearing before. Then it's school time.
My school day is either hectic, fun, or just plain boring. I have math, chem, photo, and English on one day, and history, chem, and study hall on another day. We have an alternating schedule at our school, so we don't have the same classes every day. Usually in the morning, I'm in a good mood, but depending on what day it is, my mood can turn sour from some classes. But hey, it happens to everyone. School can be pretty interesting at times. I have some pretty crazy friends.
That's an understatement.
Hey, you're one of them.
Didn't say I wasn't.
Christina and I are always loud when we're together. It can get pretty out of control, especially when you've had too much sugar that day.
And I'm left to deal with them. Why do parents send their kids to school? Because they have ADHD and don't want to deal with them. Thanks, Mrs. Thurston. Anyway, my school day isn't anything special. Study hall, chorus, photo, and history on one day, and English study hall, math, and chem on the other. I happen to like school, but I guess you have to if you're going to spend about 12 hours there each day. But more on that later. I also have pretty spastic friends. After school, I can do one of a billion things. I can have play rehearsal, GSA meeting, tennis practice or a tennis match, a Girl Scout meeting, be called to work at the hospital, hang out with friends, or go home. The likeliness I'm going home is less than 1%. On an average day, I don't get home until 7 o'clock at night. Why do you ask? Because even if my activity gets out early, I either have something else I need to do or my dad can't come get me till later. I don't usually complain because I have a lot more fun being at play practice or at Girl Scouts than sitting at home twiddling my thumbs.
Wait, Hill, you're still in Girl Scouts?
Yeah. Problem?
No. My typical day after school is driving home my boyfriend, my sister's friends, and my sister and I, because I can drive. I sometimes have to run errands for my parents or take my little sister to doctor's appointments. After that, it's home for me so I can start my homework before either going to work at a local restaurant or helping my mom out. Sometimes my friends come over during the afternoon to hang out or go watch some games. After dinner, my night usually consists of my sister and I goofing off, running around the house and getting in some sort of trouble.
So that's pretty much our day. When we're not trying to answer silly riddles, watching On the Rocks perform Lady Gaga, ingesting way too much caffeine, mispronouncing the word metal...
I'm never gonna live that one down, am I?
Or just plain goofing off, you can find us in our quiet little town enjoying our youth.
Although, you'll probably still find us goofing off.
So to end our little day in the life segment, we'd like to remind you that even though Beatrix Potter thought going to school would have rubbed off some of her originality,
we're living proof that that's impossible.
See ya!